sure you stay awake there, Karen.
Hello, Arthur.
Thank you. Excuse me, sir. Can I bother you for a minute of your time?
How do you do?
Can I tell you a little about what we're doing here?
Sure.
Less than a minute, I promise. We're trying to raise money to build an expansion to the Quincy Harris Memorial Hall. A shelter for homeless veterans and their families. Can you help? A donation of $20 would put us well on our way.
$20 ain't no chicken feed, but sure, I can help you out.
That's very kind. What is your name, sir?
Arthur Morgan.
Your donation will be acknowledged on a founder's plaque when the building is completed. You have a great day, Mr. Morgan.
Hello, mister.
Hello.
How are you, ma'am? Hey, partner.
What's new?
Hi there, mister. Damn way!
Orale, muévete!
This here the Gray Plantation?
Yep. Gallagher Hall. And that's as close as you're getting.
Hey, look, I've been helping the sheriff with some trouble. Wanted me to have a word with a few of the folks on the property here.
Emmett Lee. All right. Have a word. But I ain't got the time to help you.
Obliged.
You might be our dumbest deputy yet.
I was hoping you'd talk a moment. I'm a student of the history of the region, and,
I ain't the one to speak to. Try Master Bo. Think he's down there by the wood store. Boy's got all the time in the world.
Mister?
Evening.
Huh. I'll see you at the sheriff's office.
Excuse me, friend.
We friends?
Not yet, but he is hoping.
I guess.
We don't get a lot of traveling men here, and suddenly there's a whole phalanx of mysterious but strangely helpful Yankees about the place.
Is there?
What are you doing here?
I was just looking for work.
Well, looking for something. Don't worry, your secret's safe with me.
What secret?
I got a secret of my own.
Are you secretly normal?
Excuse me?
Never mind.
The thing is, I don't care if you kill the whole lot of us and the Braithwaites.
I don't want to kill anyone.
I love her, you know.
Love who?
Penelope. But it's impossible.
Love tends to be complicated.
She's a Braithwaite. I'm Bo Gray, son of Tavish Gray, nephew of Lee Gray, the sheriff, grandson of old Murdo Gray. We Greys have been loyal to the state and murderous to the Braithwaites for so long now, no one can even quite explain why. Beyond blind loyalty and stupidity, I'm supposed to be loyal to some nonsense while she's amazing. She's like a woman from the future. She's like tomorrow, if tomorrow turns out fine.
Well, I'm sorry for your predicament.
Would you help?
I don't want to get involved. Gang feuds. Seems unseemly.
I'll pay. I've got money. We Grays, we've always got money. No brains mind but money.
Well, in that case...
I know she loves to sit out in the gazebo on the edge of the Braithwaite property. Take her this letter and this bracelet, please.
Oh, look out for their guard. They're worse with fingers than ours.
You better follow that order, right?
Thank you.
got a spy. If you ain't working for the Braithwaites, you can't be walking here. Get out right now.
Hey, hey, I'm just a tourist.
Are you Penelope Braithwaite?
Well, yes, I am.
I've got a letter for you.
Oh.
And a gift.
A letter and a gift. Well, we don't even know each other.
Well, it's not from me. It's from,
From Bo. Oh, he is so...
strange?
Yes, he's a little strange, but also so human. The rest of our families are stuck in the Dark Ages, or... I don't know, cave people, perhaps. Bo's different. But if they find out, they'll kill him and send me to live someplace awful, like Ohio. Have you ever been to Ohio, sir?
No.
Well, neither have I. But my uncle has a factory there. He was sort of the black sheep on account of having left. But now they tolerate him because he's a vicious snob. Families are... there's something else. You got a family, sir?
No, not really.
Well, they tolerate him because of the money. But me, with my ideas above my station, they can't stand.
That sounds pretty complicated. I don't know quite what to say.
Well, nothing to say, except I hope they all rot. I don't. Well, maybe a bit. But here... if you see Bo again, will you give this to him?
Sure.
Thank you.
Hi, Arthur.
Hey, I didn't tell Dutch about the little diversion on our supply run.
Why not? I'll fight any time and any place.
Mr. Arthur.
Kieran.
Pathfinders.
Top of the world.
No way, lady.
Right here.
Not good. I won't lie.
I know the feeling.
Ah. Mr. Morgan.
Arthur.
You going fishing?
Yes.
Or running off to Como Driscoll?
Of course not.
I was joking.
That's very funny. Yes, very funny. I saved your life, and now you torture me. Ho, ho.
Shut up.
Do you want to go fishing with me? I found an interesting spot. We'll do well.
I'm not a great fisherman.
But I am. I'll teach you something. We come?
Sure.
All right, then. Grab your horse and let's go. Are you coming, then?
Come on, girl.
Okay, follow me. I know a great little fishing spot along the beach. Who'd have thought it? Wasn't that long ago I was tied to the back of your horse while begging for mercy. Now we're off fishing together.
How do you know I ain't just looking for a good place to drown you?
Because I saved your life, Arthur.
You keep saying that. But I save your life every day I don't kill you. So we are more than even on that front.
Come on, you don't mean that.
You better believe I mean it. Now where's this spot?
Not much further. This is the place. Some beautiful smallmouth here.
Bass?
Sure. This strip of shore looks perfect. Spot. Seeing lots of bluegill and bass over here. Bait with one. Or crickets if you got them. Otherwise, maybe some bread or cheese. Whoa, you're right up on me there, huh?
You getting many bites there, O'Driscoll?
I ain't an O'Driscoll. I told you fellas 100 times. I'd only been with him a couple of months. I was just a runner, helping out with the horses mainly. Bottom rung of the ladder.
And to think that was the high point of your career.
Comb goes through men like cigars. They ain't like you folks. You barely knew my name. I'm more Kieran Vanderlyn than Kieran O'Driscoll at this point. Honest to God. Mostly I'm Kieran Duffy.
I hate to break it to you, but I ain't sure Kieran Vanderlyn is gonna stick.
Not too fast. You could break the line. There you go. Nice. Good catch, Arthur. Now see if you can hook another. Why aren't you fishing? So, you think Dutch trusts me now?
That's a good one.
What?
Not in the slightest, my friend.
I can't win. I promised loyalty, he says, but you wasn't loyal to Combe. If I say I ain't got no allegiance to nobody, he says, how do I know you won't turn on us then?
I don't know what you want to hear. I'm trying hard to feel sorry for you, but somehow I just can't manage to.
What in the world? Arthur, are you seeing this? The feller's naked as a jaybird.
Is that why you like this spot?
My lord. There's somebody
hey,
who needs to go to confession.
Hey, what's the line?
Oh, hey! I nearly gulped down a minnow. Sorry, fellas. Didn't see you there. Why don't you take a break? Come on in. The water's wonderful. You here for some fishing?
We hope to. You haven't scared them all away, have you?
Oh, just so you fellas know, there's some real big ones over that way, like this. Well, I better keep the blood pumping. Hope you gents catch something.
Yeah? Maybe we'll take a look. Thanks.
I know where that is. Come on, let's go.
Take care.
Come on, let's go.
Hey, wait up! You all right, girl?
I think this is the place that naked feller was talking about.
Christ alive!
Did you see that amazing bluegill?
Sure. That got you real excited, huh?
Come on, Arthur. Let's walk down to the beach. We land this monster.
Uh-huh.
It ain't easy to catch a fish like that with bread and cheese, but you never know. We might get lucky.
Guess we'll see. Mm.
catch much if you don't cast the line.
So who taught you how to fish?
My pappy, mostly. I lost my mammy and pappy when I was young to cholera.
Your mammy?
Like I said, I was real young. After that, I was on my own pretty much, but I knew horses and fishing.
Well, just think now, you'll never be alone again.
You got it. That has got to be the one, right?
It might be. He's putting up one hell of a fight. See? Look at this. Life ain't so bad. At least you ain't tied to a tree.
I'm still a prisoner, Arthur. I can't step outside camp by myself for a second without being terrified one of Combs' boys gonna come pick me up. When I'm in camp, I got Bill and Sadie whispering in my ear all the time how they're gonna kill me in my sleep. It's like living in a nightmare.
Christ. If I'd known you were gonna moan this much, I'd have never have said yes to this.
Nice catch, but that's not the big one we saw. You got it. That has got to be the one, right?
Nah, don't feel very big to me.
No, that's not it. I don't think we have much chance. We need better bait. You might want to see if the stores around here sell anything better. I think I'm gonna head back to camp, Arthur, if that's okay.
Sure. Go on, I'll see you later. Let's go, girl. Yes, Miss O'Shea.
Ah, call me Molly, would you? Oh. Arthur, how is Dutch? I mean, how does he seem to you?
I'm about the same as usual, I guess.
I really love him, you know. But if he... Like he always says, loyalty is everything, so...
Arthur! Excuse me, Miss O'Shea.
What you want?
I bring a gift. The great gift of information.
So you got some tip-off, so now I can risk my neck and make you some money while you lounge around.
You know, Arthur, bitterness, it works on the inside as well as on your sour face.
If you say so. But you could go find some other fool to run your errands.
Bill, come on over here. Will you be my other fool? You too, Charles.
What are you talking about?
Arthur's above a little stick-up I heard about.
No, I'm not.
You just said...
Hey, I'll do it. As long as you ride with us.
I got a serious medical condition.
Yes, you are a compulsive liar.
No need to be like that. Charles, have I ever lied to you?
I hardly know you.
Exactly. Now, you boys should do this. It's easy, and I'll only take a small commission for my information. But it's now or never.
Then it's never.
Oh, God help me. Fine. I'll do it.
Well, what is it?
It's a supply wagon carrying payroll, but very briefly unguarded, apparently. As it passes through a crossroads near here where there's an old ruined church before it connects with the rest of the wagon train. Very easy picking.
As long as we get paid or you get shot, I'm happy.
You are a sick man, Arthur Morgan. A very sick man indeed. Come on then, you miserable bastards.
Yep. How do you get wind of this, old man? We've only been down here all of 5 minutes.
Well, while you boys went off fishing or playing lawman or whatever the hell you've been doing, I've been getting down to business.
Finding the nearest grog house.
Hey, you don't want in on this, Williamson. That's fine by me. Do us all a favor. Head home.
Just give it a rest, you two.
Just have a little faith for once, will you? I've been scoping jobs like this since you fellas were knee-high to a grasshopper.
Once a decade, maybe. So what is it you scoped here, exactly?
Well, I told you. There's a wagon with a lockbox passes through every week.
Okay, hold up here.
We should cover our faces.
They'll be passing through the crossroads up ahead.
When?
Soon, Williamson. Christ sakes. I should be due any time now.
Let's keep this quiet and clean. Nobody
there.
Needs to die here.
You see, gentlemen? Just like clockwork.
Easy.
Stop the wagon! I said... Try anything stupid, and we won't do anything unkind.
You know, boys, I don't want to get shot.
but this is a mistake. I work for Cornwall Kerosene and Tar. Mr. Leviticus Cornwall.
Oh, great.
So you know him?
Who doesn't?
I hear he's rich enough to share the wealth around and not miss it too much.
Oh, he'll miss it.
Shit! Hey! Think I see something!
Oh, great.
Let's go!
Arthur, let's go! Yeah!
Stay until dark, and then we'll sneak out of here.
Charles, you keep watch for now.
Sure.
Well, we get some rest. All right. Let's try and get out of here.
Hey, shit!
Absolutely. Shut up, old man.
Look, I was just trying to...
Shut up. There's a light over by the house.
Damn. I hate it. Now let's just keep this calm. See what happens.
Is this your place?
Kinda. And you didn't hear nothing? Why don't you just tell me, partner, what you heard?
Good. Tell me what you heard.
I don't... Maybe I heard some noises out by the barn a while ago. Ain't me.
Better not be. All right. Coop forth. Lo, go check out the barn.
Sir.
Place looks deserted enough.
Sure. You head inside, I'll go around the back.
Place looks empty to me. Now, the old guy up there is full of crap.
I don't think they're here. Don't see any horses.
Come on, let's head back. Boss! Place is empty!
Shit!
Give him hell, Wolf!
Where are they all coming from?
Looks like Mr. Cornwall's going up to security.
We got more of the bastards on this side!
Can't get out of this.
No!
assholes in the army too? Can't you keep your pet feet still for 10 goddamn seconds?
You got us into this!
Take the left, and I'll take the right, okay?
Your right or my right?
You see anything?
Not yet.
Follow my lead.
Bastard! Get the hell off me! Arthur!
Made a meal out of that, didn't you?
Oh, just stand there, why don't you?
I'm making an old man suffer.
See you in hell! Uh-oh! Clearly those boys ain't as quiet as us.
Guess we should go give him a hand.
Some money, didn't we?
Sure, but now we got Cornwall on our backs.
It was an honest mistake.
Hey, leave it, go on, get out of here. Every man split up, go on, run, quick.
Good luck, gents.
Stay quiet and move. Okay then, girl.
Dumbass.
Good to see you back, Arthur.
Load up.
Did good, girl.
Flatter me.
Tell me some stories about when you was young and pretty. Where time ravaged you.
You horrible man.
That's right.